I thank the hosts of the evening for giving an opportunity before I leave Belgium once again to see all of you, so that I remember our affectionate hosts and all our people all through the year until I see them once again. So I can say it is a sweet gathering before we depart for this year. Today I am asked to speak about homeopathy and how the treatment is positive. I think it is to understand how the homeopathic approach is better than the other approaches. Of course, every system has its own advantages, and the more advanced the system is, the more advantages it is to mankind. Advanced does not mean up to date according to the calendar, and advanced does not mean accepted by scientific academies of various countries and universities. The real scientific value and the real advanced nature can be decided only by the results something gives us. Let it be a science or an art or any technology or any method followed, it is the results that decide if the method adopted is advanced or not. That should be the right measure to measure a thing, if one is advanced, one subject is advanced or not. When we apply this measure, we find definitely homeo standing among the foremost methods of healing, especially when we are losing our heart after 2 or 3 centuries experimentation with material medicine and material way of approach for cure. Understanding the human constitution in terms of materialistic body, which we call the anatomical understanding, that is the bony system, the nervous system, the circulatory system, the respiratory system. Each system speaking a tissue of our body. That means the matter that makes the tissue. And there is very little about the forces that govern the matter in our body. We learn much about the chemistry of the various tissues of our body and the change in the chemistry of the tissues, which is understood as disease, and the changes we are expected to make once again in the same tissues by applying some more materialistic substance called medicine. This is how we understood until about the middle of this century, because there is a break in the scientific understanding through centuries, and the previous 3 or 4 centuries lost the threads of real science of healing. Until almost the end of the last century, the Western mind believed nothing except matter. And you know, the scientists and the foremost thinkers who spoke about forces and other things different from matter, and those scientists who could understand something different from matter were punished and sometimes killed in the accident. For example, if something is discovered that the earth was going round the sun and the sun was not going round the earth, it was something very new to the accident then, and they killed him on the street. So until the middle of this century, medical science also was only of the same nature, materialistic nature. And as a result, the traditional medicine of other nations, like the Indian, the Chinese, Japanese, the Arabic, and the Greek, they also were killed by imitating the Occidental medicine. And now we have very many difficulties once again to understand the original scientific threads of ancient medicine. We have real difficulties in understanding Hippocrates and Paracelsus because we broke out from such great lights, and through 3 or 4 centuries we wasted away our time in materialistic way of understanding disease. And that materialistic dimension of science is capable of teaching about health. Therefore, it is spending all its time in teaching about disease and its cure. The present students of medicine in the university or college burns away 5 years or 6 years of his valuable time, because he has to learn what is disease and how it is cured. He has nothing to learn what is health and how it is maintained. The tradition is broken and lost. The so-called most modern medicine of the century has no message to give about health. So, under these dangerous conditions, we got a message from above, and a messenger who is once again the Messiah who came to earth. The message is what we call homeopathy, and the Messiah is whom we call Dr. Samuel Hahnemann. It was really one of the dangerous critical periods of the health of mankind that he came down to earth with a proper understanding of health. Now we will try to make a little comparison to understand the advantages of homeopathy over the popular materialistic way of understanding disease, and the impossibility of having health according to the materialistic way of understanding, and the impossibility of getting a cure with material medicine. Now, the physical body is taken as a separate entity by the materialistic medical science, and when there is some trouble to any part of the physical body, attempts are made to do something to the affected part, forgetting that the human constitution is a living constitution and that the parts do not exist without the total. It is a blind way of unscientific understanding that something happens independently somewhere in the body. For example, pain in the stomach, pain in the kidneys, pain in the liver, or pain in the knee, each is considered to be some disturbance independent of the person concerned. It is the characteristic of the present century, such a way of understanding every subject in a wrong perspective, losing the total and gaining the detail of a part of it, because we are living in a century which is essentially political in its nature. Even humanity we can understand only in groups, not in totality. For a human creature of the 20th century, it is very, very difficult to remember that he is a part of the total humanity of this globe, because the present human creature is not well evolved enough to remember it. So everyone remembers himself as belonging to a country, and also in that little country belonging to south or north, and also very little speaking either French or Flemish or something differently, each thinking separately about himself, like the so many worms that are found in a diseased part of one body. And even in a town or city, a group thinking themselves belonging to one party, another group belonging to another party, trying to fight each other. It is the formula of the human creature of the 20th century. That is, to disintegrate into groups, to divide into little and more little groups, to create wars and destruction. So, we cannot understand. It is very difficult for us to understand a part belonging to the whole. Therefore, now when there is some trouble to the skin of my hand, the popular way of treating or curing is that particular portion is cured by the doctor, refusing to think that it is only a part of the total person, and the result is a total failure of the whole attempt. Unless there is something in the person going wrong, there cannot be something going wrong in any part of the body. This way of understanding is absolutely impossible in the materialistic way of treatment. So, homeopathy once again renovated the understanding of the man as a total being. Into each part having a specialist to treat it, so that if I have a toothache, I should go only to the dental specialist, and that also upper dental specialist, the one who has specialized the fifth upper molar, and he makes a treatment this morning. Tomorrow he is in Brussels. If I go to the hospital, the next doctor says, no, no, I am a specialist in the next tooth. So go to Brussels. So with the pain and the hand pushing the tooth upwards, he has to run to Brussels. Such is the most unscientific state of the present medical condition. The false science called specialization. But in the ancient days, we have the understanding of man as a constitution, having all these as principles in him, so that the doctor was not permitted to have a specialization. It was scientific enough to permit only to understand in a holistic way. He was not allowed to understand the body separately, and the psychologist is not there to understand the mind separately, and the cardiologist the heart separately, so that the person may not exist and the parts exist. But always in the healing sciences of the various ancient races and nations, it was the person who was understood by the doctors, and then only the parts understood in the person. That is the synthetic understanding of the human being, on the background of which there is the analytical understanding. That is the vital understanding of a human person, and then only the anatomical understanding of his structure. So this great tradition of the ancient nations is there as the inheritance of man, which worked upon Dr. Samuel Hahnemann and focused a new dimension of science of healing upon his mind. Once again, for the first time after so many centuries, he gave out the formula that it is the patient who is to be cured and not at all the disease. This is the first modification that Hahnemann brought in the medical science. So, from the unscientific understanding of the science of disease and its cure, his followers could come to the scientific understanding of the patient and the science of health, making a rectification in the patient, not curing the disease, because this disease has no existence. It is only the person who is existing. When everything is normal, health is existing with him. And when something is wrong, disease is existing with him. So health or disease do not exist independently. And it is unscientific to accept a disease and its existence, because what we wrongly call disease is only the result of something going wrong in us. This gave a great renaissance in the understanding of the human constitution. A true homeopath who can understand the principles of Hahnemann and his followers decides medicine only to the patient, not to the disease. If you say, I want medicine for headache, there is no medicine in homeopathy. Because headache is a disease. If I say, I am suffering from stomachache, can you tell me a medicine? The answer in homeopathy is, no, I cannot tell you anything. Because stomachache is only the suffering and result of a disease. The physical body shows tissue changes. The body of forces or vital body shows disturbance of functions. And the mind or the mental body shows abnormalities or distortions in behavior when there is something wrong in the constitution. The three put together are called disease. And disease starts first as mental abnormalities and then extends as the disturbance of the functions of the body. For example, the digestion, the elimination of urine and stool, and the functions of the senses, etc. So, and then if it is neglected, it descends upon the physical matter of the tissues, begins to produce sensations that are disagreeable. For example, stiffness or pain or headache or stiffness of the neck. Like this, the next change that takes place is on the physical tissues. That is, disturbances in the tissue production, what we call the cysts, the polyp, the corns, etc. Corns, which are unscientifically understood as separate diseases and locally treated. But if you go to a true and scientific homeopath, he will select a medicine on three grounds: mental abnormalities, and then disturbances in vital functions called modalities, and then disturbance in the physical tissues. The patient comes to the doctor and can report only these. He can never report the other two things. Not only the patient, but the most educated modern medical man in the materialistic medicine can speak only about the tissue changes of the patient in the name of clinical tests and the results. And he has no understanding of what Hahnemann and his followers call modalities and mentals. It is the duty of the true homeopath to educate the patients so that they may not be any more patients, and also they may understand how to report a case to the doctor properly. Then, if the same patient, after he is cured, if he takes his wife or children or grandchildren to a good homeopathic doctor, he will be able to report the required things to the doctor and not the unnecessary. But before that, we should not discourage a patient that he is talking only unnecessary things. We should be able to extract the information we want from the patient himself. When you question the patient, what is the trouble with him? He says, polyp. That is, only physical tissue changes. He says only one word, says polyp, and stops. Then, how long since, you should question. Then he begins to speak about, he says, I was having crisis of asthma. Then you question, was it earlier or the polyp earlier? He says, the polyp earlier. Polyp started in my 18th year. Asthma started in my 24th year. Then you can understand that the polyp is suppressed by touching with an acid or cauterization, and the fellow developed asthma. So you will understand the sequence and the logic of the disease. And then you question the patient, were you having asthma when you were a child? He says, yes, my mother used to say that I was having asthma when I was a little child. Now you make a rectification in your understanding that his asthma was earlier, not his polyp. If you question him, why you say your polyp is earlier when you had asthma in childhood? He says, no, that is infantile asthma, that is different. సో యూ షుడ్ నాట్ గెట్ ఇరిటేటెడ్ విత్ ది పేషెంట్ యూ షుడ్ ట్రై టు అండర్స్టాండ్ ఇట్ దిస్ గివ్స్ యూ ది మోడాలిటీస్ అట్ ఫస్ట్ హీ హ్యాడ్ ఆస్తమా ఇట్ బికేమ్ బెటర్ విత్ పోలిప్ సో హీ వాజ్ హ్యావింగ్ ఆస్తమా ఇన్ చైల్డ్హుడ్ అండ్ హీ డెవలప్డ్ ఎ పోలిప్ సమ్వేర్ ఇన్ ది ఇయర్ ఆర్ నోస్ ఆర్ సమ్వేర్ అండ్ హీస్ ఆస్తమా డిసపియర్డ్ అండ్ దెన్ విత్ ది పోలిప్ హీ వెంట్ టు ఎ మెటీరియలిస్టిక్ డాక్టర్ హూ ట్రీటెడ్ ఓన్లీ ది పోలిప్ అండ్ నాట్ ది బాయ్ సో హీ హ్యాస్ డన్ హిస్ వర్క్ యాజ్ ఎ బార్బర్ ఆర్ ఎ లిటిల్ బుచర్ సో ది పోలిప్ వాజ్ మేడ్ ఎ బుచరీ అండ్ దెన్ ఆస్తమా వర్స్ వితౌట్ పోలిప్ దిస్ ఈజ్ కాల్డ్ వన్ మోడాలిటీ ఆఫ్ ది పేషెంట్ లైక్ దిస్ యూ కెన్ గ్యాదర్ టూ ఆర్ త్రీ మోడాలిటీస్ దట్ ఈస్ వాట్ వీ వాంట్ బికాస్ దే ఫార్మ్ ది ఆల్ఫబెట్ ఆఫ్ ది వైటల్ ఫోర్స్ ఆఫ్ ది పేషెంట్ జస్ట్ యాజ్ ది పేషెంట్ ఈజ్ స్పీకింగ్ టు యూ హీస్ వైటల్ ఫోర్స్ ఈజ్ ఆల్సో స్పీకింగ్ టు యూ ఇట్ హ్యాస్ ఇట్స్ ఓన్ ఆల్ఫబెట్ ఇట్ హ్యాస్ ఇట్స్ ఓన్ సెంటెన్సెస్ విచ్ యు ఆర్ ఎక్స్పెక్టెడ్ టు రీడ్ దట్ ఆల్ఫబెట్ అండ్ దట్ లాంగ్వేజ్ ఈజ్ స్టార్ట్ బై హ్యానిమన్ సో ఫ్రమ్ ది లాంగ్వేజ్ ఆఫ్ ది పేషెంట్ యూ షుడ్ ట్రావెల్ టు ది లాంగ్వేజ్ ఆఫ్ ది వైటల్ ఫోర్స్ అండ్ దెన్ హీ హ్యాస్ హిజ్ మైండ్ విచ్ ఈజ్ ఆల్వేజ్ హ్యావింగ్ టూ లేయర్స్ వన్ ఈజ్ ది మైండ్ హీ ఈజ్ కాన్షియస్ ఆఫ్ ది అదర్ ఈజ్ ది మైండ్ విచ్ ఈజ్ మేకింగ్ హిమ్ కాన్షియస్ సో ది హయ్యర్ మైండ్ విల్ రివీల్ ది సీక్రెట్స్ టు యూ దట్ కాజెస్ హిజ్ బిహేవియర్ వేర్ యాజ్ ది కాన్షియస్ మైండ్ కాజెస్ ది సీక్వెన్స్ ఆఫ్ ఇన్సిడెంట్స్ హీ డస్ హౌ హీ డస్ ఈజ్ డిసైడెడ్ బై ది హయ్యర్ మైండ్ వెన్ యూ రీడ్ ఏ బుక్ అండ్ ఐ రీడ్ ది సేమ్ బుక్ యువర్ వే ఆఫ్ అండర్స్టాండింగ్ ది బుక్ ఈజ్ క్వైట్ డిఫరెంట్ ఫ్రమ్ మై వే ఆఫ్ అండర్స్టాండింగ్ ది బుక్ బట్ టు రీడ్ ది బుక్ అండ్ అండర్స్టాండ్ ది సెంటెన్సెస్ ఇట్ ఈస్ ది లోయర్ మైండ్ దట్ ఈస్ రిక్వైర్డ్ టు గో టు ది యూనివర్సిటీ అండ్ స్టడీ ది బుక్స్ అండ్ లిసన్ టు ప్రొఫెసర్స్ ఇట్ ఈస్ ది లోయర్ మైండ్ దట్ ఈస్ రిక్వైర్డ్ టు గెట్ మోర్ మార్క్స్ ఇన్ ది యూనివర్సిటీ ఇట్ ఈస్ ది లోయర్ మైండ్ దట్ ఈస్ రిక్వైర్డ్ అండ్ టు గెట్ యువర్ ప్రొఫెషన్ బెటర్ దాన్ ఎర్లియర్ దాన్ యువర్ కొలీగ్ ఇట్ ఈస్ ది లోయర్ మైండ్ దట్ ఈస్ రిక్వైర్డ్ బట్ హౌ యూ బిహేవ్ అండ్ వాట్ యూ కెన్ అండర్స్టాండ్ ది మెథడ్ ఇన్ విచ్ యూ మేక్ ఏ సింథసిస్ ఆఫ్ సబ్జెక్ట్ ది మెథడ్ ఇన్ విచ్ యూ మేక్ ఏ లాజిక్ ఆఫ్ ది సబ్జెక్ట్ ఈజ్ డిసైడెడ్ బై ది హయ్యర్ మైండ్ విచ్ షోస్ యూ ది అబ్నార్మాలిటీస్ ఆఫ్ ది పేషెంట్ సమ్టైమ్స్ ది పేషెంట్ ఈజ్ ఇంపేషెంట్ ఇఫ్ యూ క్వశ్చన్ హిమ్ ఫర్ ఎ సెకండ్ టైమ్ డూ యూ హ్యావ్ కాన్స్టిపేషన్ ఫస్ట్ టైమ్ హీ ఆన్సర్స్ నో సెకండ్ టైమ్ ఆఫ్టర్ 5 మినిట్స్ యూ స్పీక్ సమ్ అదర్ థింగ్స్ అండ్ లెట్ హిమ్ ఫర్గెట్ దట్ యూ ఆస్క్డ్ హిమ్ ది క్వశ్చన్ 5 మినిట్స్ ఎగో అండ్ ఏ సెకండ్ టైమ్ యూ క్వశ్చన్ హిమ్ దెన్ హీ సేస్ ఏ లిటిల్ సో వెన్ వీ క్వశ్చన్ ఫర్ ది ఫస్ట్ టైమ్ ది ఆన్సర్ వాజ్ రాదర్ కాన్స్టిపేటెడ్ అండ్ ది సెకండ్ టైమ్ ఇట్ ఈస్ లెస్ కాన్స్టిపేట్ లైక్ దట్ యూ విల్ హ్యావ్ యువర్ డ్యూటీస్ టువర్డ్స్ హిస్ బిహేవియర్ అండ్ ఆఫ్టర్ 5 మినిట్స్ వన్స్ అగైన్ ఇఫ్ యూ క్వశ్చన్ ఫర్ ఎ థర్డ్ టైమ్ హీ సేస్ ఐ కేమ్ టు యూ ఫర్ హెడేక్స్ ఇఫ్ యూ హ్యావ్ ఎనీథింగ్ టు డూ ప్లీజ్ డూ దట్ ఈస్ వాట్ హీ రిప్లైస్ దట్ మీన్స్ యు ఆర్ నాట్ ది లీస్ట్ కన్సర్న్డ్ ఫర్ సంథింగ్ విచ్ ఐ డిడ్ నాట్ రిపోర్ట్ టు యూ యాజ్ ఎ డాక్టర్ ఓన్లీ బీ కన్సర్న్డ్ యాజ్ మచ్ యాజ్ ఐ డిమాండ్ ఫ్రమ్ యూ సో ది సెకండ్ పాయింట్ యూ విల్ అండర్స్టాండ్ ఈజ్ దట్ హీఈస్ ఇరిటబుల్ నోట్ డౌన్ ఇన్ యువర్ బుక్ దట్ హీఈస్ ఇరిటబుల్ అండ్ దెన్ After 5 minutes, question him, have you a little bit of impatience and irritability? He proves that he has. Because he questions, what do you mean? I want medicine for headache. So he proves that he is impatient and irritable. These are the things which decide. And the second modality is he is having great thirst while he has asthmatic attacks. But in the first column he gives only asthma and polyp. You can ask him, do you like warm water to drink when you are having asthma or cool water? He says thirst for warm water. He never likes cool. If he touches cold water, his crisis becomes more. That is what he says. You have gathered the second point. Because you have no medicine for asthma in homeopathy. You have no medicine for polyp. For any disease, if you give a medicine, it will be a thorough failure. These two items put together make the person. The last column is the disease. It is to the person you have to select and not to the disease. And then you will question him, is he better in cool weather or warm weather? He says, I am better in warm weather and not in cool weather. And always, especially in the winters, I have too much. When it is summer, I am better. So you have a third point to understand. Now, he is irritable, impatient, and he is having some other mental symptom also. And he has three modalities. You gather all these things. And he said he is having constipation, for which you have no medicine, because it is a disease. But here he says, whenever there is a tendency to constipation, he has his asthma broken out. Whenever his asthma is better, whenever his constipation is better, his asthma is better. Note down that